Pay taxes, provide homeowners insurance, climate change matters to you. One way or another, you're paying for the property, paying for it in your taxes, paying for it in your insurance rates, even if you're not anywhere that floods. You have nobody with asthma or COPD in your family, whatever. You could be far away from this, but still, it's a pocketbook issue, and it's the costs of these insurance damages get amortized through the entire national and international pool of insurance payers. So it affects you. It affects all of us. We know that the cost of FEMA, the Federal Emergency Management Agency, that money doesn't come from outer space. It comes from your taxes. And the more money that FEMA has to pay out to fix a hurricane in Louisiana, or the consequences of a hurricane in Louisiana, or Texas, or Florida, or North Carolina, anywhere else, it's coming out of your pocketbook somewhere or another. So it touches all of us, and I try and remember that all the time. And to me, the question always comes up, well, you know, there's all of you in the audience, and everybody's sitting there going, well, what can I do? It's just me. What can I do? You know, we have an admiral here. We have a Chesapeake Bay person over there. We have this communicator here. But what can I do? Audience member John Smith. Well, the answer is you use your voice. You use your voice. And your voice is manifested in a lot of different ways. It manifests in the fact that you vote and how you vote. It manifests in the vehicles that you drive, the foods you eat, how you try and reshape your family, the world around you. You have a role to play in this. As I said in the beginning, none of us are outside the problem, and we're not outside the solutions. We can each take our own little sliver of reality and bend it in a more positive direction. Use your voice.
Very, very good.